Did you know that Huskies can actually run over 100 miles a day? That's like running 4 marathons in a single day. Yeah, some Huskies are even capable of running 1,000 miles in just over a week. And in 1925, a group of Huskies saved the lives of an entire Alaskan town thanks to their incredible endurance and ability to run long distances. Interested in knowing how? Stick around! In today's episode, we're examining the extraordinary stamina of the Husky and why they're able to run such a ridiculous distance. And that all starts right now on The Smart Canine, the only show that explores the most interesting stories and facts behind dogs. But before we dive in, hit that subscribe button and notification bell if you want to hear more incredible dog stories like this. Often called the dog with a thousand expressions, Siberian Huskies have given us plenty of hilarious memes and moments in life. They're silly, funny, and love getting into trouble with their seemingly unlimited levels of energy. But like all dogs, there's a reason why Huskies are the way they are. You see, Huskies have been bred to pull sleds for hundreds of years. They needed this crazy amount of energy so that they could travel long distances while carrying a load. But just how much can the Siberian Husky run? Before we answer this, let's take into consideration the average dog. Most dogs can run anywhere between 2 to 5 miles in a single day. Some dogs are built for achieving high speeds in a short amount of time, such as the Greyhound, who can reach a speed of 35 miles per hour. Others are built for endurance and long distance running, such as the Siberian Husky. And then there are dogs like the French Bulldog, who aren't suited for running more than they do while playing with other dogs. The typical everyday Husky is capable of running 40 miles per day. That is, if they're in decent shape. That's roughly 10 times more than the majority of all dog breeds. However, a conditioned, trained, and genetically gifted Husky is more than capable of reaching 100 miles per day, and oftentimes, even more. But how do we know this? What Husky has ever run this insane amount of mileage? Well, every year, there are many dog sled events held in Alaska that test the endurance, determination, willpower, and speed of sled dogs from around the world. Huskies aren't the only dogs to compete in these races, though most of them are. You'll see a variety of Siberian Huskies, Alaskan Malamutes, Alaskan Huskies, and even some hybrids. In these events, the races are broken down into three types. You have the sprints, mid-distance, and the long distance. Sprint races cover a much shorter distance, clocking in anywhere from 4 to 25 miles per day. Mid-distance races cover a total distance of 100 to 300 miles within a span of 2 or 3 days. However, the holy grail of this dog sport lies in long-distance racing. These races can cover a total distance of 300 to 1,000 miles in a span of a few days to a couple of weeks. And the most famous long-distance dog sled race of them all is none other than the Iditarod Trail Race that spans 1,100 miles and wiggles through the entire state of Alaska. This annual race happens just once a year in March, attracting over 100 participants and their 16-member dog sled teams. Not only are the dogs expected to travel 100-mile days, but also do so in blistering cold temperatures while battling wind chills that frequently blow through the trail. It's not an easy feat, yet thousands of Huskies have successfully completed this trail, most of which, in record time, you wouldn't believe. What's even more fascinating is the rapid improvement of these Husky teams over time. For instance, in 1974, Carl Huntington won the race with a time of 20 days, 15 hours, 2 minutes, and 7 seconds. Fast forward to 2017, and the all-time record was broken by Mitch Seavey and his Huskies, who conquered the trail in just 8 days, 3 hours, 40 minutes, and 13 seconds. That's more than twice as fast. Now, if you break it down, this meant that Seavey's Huskies had to reach around 137 miles per day. For comparison, that's like if your Husky ran from Los Angeles to Mexico in a single day, or like running across the entire width of the state of Indiana. And keep in mind that these dogs have an entire sled, supplies, and a human strapped to them. It's simply incredible what a Husky's stamina can become with the proper training. But how is it that they're able to expend so much energy for such a long duration of time? Where is this energy all coming from? According to Scientific American, researchers have identified a metabolic switch that happens in Huskies during long-distance racing. In the 2005 study, drivers ran their Huskies through 100-mile races for 4 to 5 days straight. However, after every 100 miles, researchers took a small sample of the dog's leg muscles to test for protein levels, enzyme activity, and various other factors. When animals eat food, their bodies transform the carbs into a form of sugar called glucose, which is then used to provide energy. Glucose is then transformed into glycogen, which can easily be stored in the animal's muscles. But what the scientists found with the huskies was nothing short of an unusual and extraordinary. During the first few days of the race, dog sleds draw energy from the glycogen stored inside the muscles. Most animals typically do. But as the sled dogs need to go into overdrive, a metabolic switch goes off and they start to draw energy from sources outside their muscles. Instead, muscle cells begin to extract fat directly from the bloodstream, where it can then be used as energy fuel. During races, huskies would have a buildup of fat in their bloodstream thanks to the high-fat diet that these dogs consume. But don't worry, huskies are well equipped to handle the high amount of fat because they contain more cellular power plants than virtually any other animal. What still remains a mystery, though, is how the fat in the bloodstream can get into the cells in the first place. Before you throw your husky into a 1,000-mile race, keep in mind that this metabolic switch is not as developed in your everyday average husky, if at all. It's likely that this physical gift was the result of breeding, having descended from long champion lines of racing dogs dating back several generations. And although you may think the unreal energy reserve of the husky may be more annoying than useful, there has been a lot of good to come out of their special power. For example, in 1925, a group of huskies saved a small remote town in Alaska from a potential devastating outbreak of a deadly disease. Unfortunately, there was a diphtheria epidemic happening in the town of Nome, Alaska, and it threatened the lives of thousands of people. The only way to save the small town was to transport the antitoxin. There was one small problem, though. The town was 674 miles away from the serum, and it just happened to be the most brutal winter in several decades. The incoming blizzard ruled out any possibility of air transportation, and the isolated town of sick residents became a nightmare scenario. However, the solution proposed was to assemble a relay of 20 sled dog teams, led by Alaska's most decorated driver, Leonhard Zapala. And just like that, the Great Race of Mercy, as it's known today, had started. It took just 5.5 days for the collective effort of dogs to reach Nome and deliver the life-saving serum. But throughout the relay delivery, two huskies shined the brightest as they made the final leg of the town during a full-on blizzard. Balto and Togo were the two huskies that both led their team on a 264-mile journey to the finish line. And for reference, the other teams only completed 31 miles each on average. Both dogs quickly became national heroes, with Balto and Togo receiving a statue in New York's Central Park and Seward Park, respectively. Now that we understand just how huskies can run over 100 miles per day, it may not be a great idea to push your dog's limits. The average husky really only needs about 2 hours of exercise a day, and not necessarily 10 hours of extreme running. Compared to most dogs, the exercise needs of a husky are already a lot. Plus, most owners may not even be able to handle the 2 hours. It's also worth noting that huskies should not run in the heat. In fact, huskies are more prone to overheating than other dogs due to their thick double coats that were built to withstand sub-zero temperatures. And it's highly unlikely that your husky has the genetics of a robust metabolic switch unless they were bred from a long line of sled dogs. But even so, it's fascinating to see just what these dogs can do when you push their physical limits through several generations of purpose breeding and proper training. So, what do you think about the husky's incredible ability to run long distances? Are there any other animals that can compare to these sled dogs? Leave a comment below and tell us what you think. You'll also want to share this video with your husky friends to let them know just how extraordinary these dogs really are. And if you enjoyed this video, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to The Smart Canine for the most interesting stories and facts behind dogs. And with that, we're gone.